Well, Janice Dickinson is one of the world's first supermodels, and over her five-decade career, she's graced countless magazine covers. But her life is much more than simply being a cover girl. She's an inspiration, an advocate for abuse survivors. She's overcome addiction, is happy, content, and has now turned her hand to acting. I got to Zoom with Janice talking about her brand new project, and she was very candid about her life. And look, a warning, this interview might be distressing to some.
Would you like me to seduce you?
Before Elle, Naomi, Claudia and Linda, there was Janice. I'm talking Janice Dickinson, who is one of the world's great supermodels, a hugely in-demand cover girl of the 70s and 80s. But as she climbed higher up that fame ladder, her life behind the scenes was far from picture perfect.
There was alcohol, there were drugs, there were pills, there was cocaine. Then I just thought, oh, I'll just have one bubbly. And I tumbled off the runway.
Janice's early life was traumatic, thanks to her father, Ray, whom she describes as a tyrant and a monster, regularly abusing Janice, as well as one of her sisters and their mother.
The worst thing you could do to a child is physically abuse them and verbally abuse them, which I had every single day. My father was a rageaholic. He'd lock me in closets. He liked locking me away in places.
But the whole bizarre aspect of that is he treated you so appallingly because you wouldn't have sex with him.
Oh, I wouldn't. There's no way. You know, he was just creepy and I literally hated him. You know, I was getting beaten. He was molesting my older sister. I was aware of it. And I'm telling this so anyone out there that's listening, if they've gone through this type of abuse, please tell a friend.
Then one day, Janice had had enough and threw away the medication he needed for his heart problems, something she believes may have hastened his death. But for Janice, it meant freedom.
He was beating the crap out of my mother because he wanted the keys to the car and she kept taking them away from him. He had dementia, Alzheimer's, and he would punch her in the face. And I was witnessing all this in my 30s, and I had just had a child. And he started kicking my mom, he started kicking my child, and I just said, wait a minute. That's when I called the police, and I called for an ambulance. I got into my car chasing the ambulance, and my mother said that the last minute, make sure he gets to take these pills for his heart. Well, I was looking at the pills in the car driving towards the hospital following the ambulance, and I just pushed the window down, and I just threw them out the window, and I knew what I was doing, and I didn't say a word to the doctors about his heart. You know, maybe I could have prevented it. I don't know, but I hope I didn't.
You became one of the world's most famous and in-demand supermodels. How did it feel to be in that space, Janice?
Well, it's a dream job that I worked very hard at.
You make me want to be a better man.
I love you.
You and Jack Nicholson apparently had a thing. We all love Jack Nicholson. Is he as fascinating in person as we imagine him to be?
Jack Nicholson is like one of the most creative men on the planet. I dated him a couple of times and we had fun. It wasn't meant to be in the long run because I kind of knew he was a womanizer.
Janice, you wrote a fabulous memoir, and in that you talk about an experience you had in Italy. You're on a runway for a shoot for Valentino.
There was all this champagne that laid out on silver trays, and I just thought, oh, I'll just have one bubbly. Well, one turned to three. Then I was feeling no pain, and I was really ready to rock this runway. Well, the lights were all dimmed. And by the time I got to the end of the runway, that's when the lights came on, and I couldn't see where the runway ended. And I tumbled off the runway into the arms of Sophia Loren, of all people. I was like, oh my God, I'm such a fan, Miss Loren. But I wasn't drunk. I was just a little tipsy.
Janice has been blisteringly candid about her demons and reveals that while modeling, she began using a cocktail of drugs.
I became addicted to Ambien. There was alcohol, there were drugs, there were pills, there was cocaine. Obviously, I couldn't take it all the time. How would I be able to work if I was up partying all night? So I kept the partying down to like the weekends, which sometimes they turned into long weekends.
and the personal turmoil continued for Janice. She claims that in 1982, Bill Cosby raped her. Janice was 27.
He had slipped me a pill with red wine, and you know I'm not supposed to drink, and you know I'm not supposed to take pills. And then I ended up at his hotel room, and against my will, he started having his way with me, if you want. It was a horrible experience because I was like not consenting to this absolutely at all. Afterwards, I took this whole entire memory away, and I didn't come forth with this information until the other women were coming forth with it.
And in 2018, she testified against the disgraced comedian in court.
I'm grateful to have walked through that because he got sentenced some time in prison. Inevitably, he got off that prison sentence by some technicality with the law, which really infuriated me. But I think to this day, he still doesn't think he did anything wrong.
Dealing with addictions can be stressful.
Life has come full circle now for Janice. In fact, she's playing Dr. Janice, a rehab counsellor, in a new comedy series, Barbie Rehab.
How would you describe the series?
You have to really watch this show to know how zany and off the charts it is. It will become an occult following, I'm sure.
Janice has survived over five decades in the fashion and entertainment biz and journeyed the many highs and devastating lows. But today, Janice is an inspiration, and she says her life is finally where it should be, serene, happily married, and a devoted mum.
Some decades are better than other decades. I'm in the middle of a good decade right now. Having done this show, the Barbie Rehab, I can tell you it was just too much fun for me to even tell you about.
I haven't looked like this in God knows when.
Oh, wow. Janice's hilarious new cult series, Barbie Rehab, is available online, and you can find it at Tubi TV. And remember, if you ever need help, Lifeline is available 24 hours, 7 days a week, and the number is 13 11 14.
Great interview, Craigie. Oh, really well done.
Thanks, Craig.
She is incredible, that's for sure.